by the end of the 17th century, we had approximately 870 sugarcane plantations on the island, as well as 500 Dutch-style windmills. Today, dotted along our landscape, we can still find approximately 150 of those ruins of windmills. Windmills had the machinery on the inside and wooden sails. On the inside, the machinery would have been turned by oxen or donkeys or mules. And the machinery would have crushed the juice from the sugarcane to take to the boiler house close by. Until the 1960s, the refining of brown sugar from sugarcane would have been our main industry. In the 1960s, also saw Barbados exporting the highest tonnage of sugarcane ever, sorry, of brown sugar ever. And that would have been well over 200,000 tons. Today we're lucky if we export 20,000 tons of sugarcane to the United Kingdom, because we still have a contract to supply it with brown muscovado sugar. Muscovado sugar has a high molasses content because the byproduct is actually molasses. So it's one of the healthier and better sugars, better quality sugars. Now, once our brown sugar gets to the United Kingdom, it's refined even further into the finest of confectionery sugars. So this is sugarcane on my right currently. Sugarcane takes approximately 18 months before it can be harvested. It's mostly cut or harvested using the big machines. Recognition as the king and queen of the crop. Throughout the festival, we have, for example, cultural events as well as various calypso competitions. Music here in the Caribbean is very important to us. The beautiful calypso plays a major part of the Crapover Festival. Now, calypso music is not just party music like ole, 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 feeling hot, hot, hot. Now, calypso music can also be very important social commentary. So you have your calypso competitions where those singers will have songs either about religion or something political. Here on the left, Andrews, that's an old sugarcane factory which would have been first built in 1902. Andrews, we still use the boiling method for making the sugarcane, for making the brown sugar. Now our Crapover Festival comes to an end always in August. That's always a public holiday. And that's when we have Carnival on the island with music and the big costume bands. People coming from all over the world to participate in our carnival. And that's going to be the third best carnival. Yes, you see the tree on the right with the orange flower? That's the North African tulip tree. Barbados is officially a part of the Lesser Antilles. The closest island to us would be St. Vincent, which is located 100 miles to the southeast of Barbados. You spread this reddish tinge of soy here in the Scotland district where we are now. The soy is reddish. There is a very high clay content in the soy. The children, all of our school children wear school uniform. We have one of, yes, the poinsettia on the left. We have one of the 10 best school systems in the world. We are up there with Belgium and Finland. Every child on the island of Barbados has a right to go to school between the ages of 4 and 16. You can find Barbadian children in school sometimes as early as 3 years old. We place a lot of emphasis on education. All of the schools once more wear uniform, and that's regardless of if the school is public or private. Each school has a different color as well as a different fashion, so you can always recognize a child by the uniform. You can always recognize the school. We have our primary schools, children between the ages of 4 and 11. We also have our secondary schools.
This is the Scotland district.
The gravel and the sand go into the building industry or construction industry, and we also mine sand to go into cement production. We manufacture and export cement from the island of Barbados. Occasionally, those of you on the right will have glimpses of the East Coast or the Atlantic Ocean. Now, this area, the Scotland district, was so named because it reminded the first settlers of the gentle rolling hills and home left behind in Scotland. Majority of the rainfall each year. It gets more than twice the amount compared to the coastal areas. Now, in the Scotland district, we have lots of palms, lots of fruit trees. Look at the bright fruit trees on the right with the very large leaves. And lots of bananas. We are in the parish of St. Joseph, heading to St. Thomas, the center of the island. The longest point on the island is 21 miles, and the widest point is 15 miles. So just to give you a little idea, it's very misty today. So now, the bananas. Bananas, and occasionally you get a glimpse of papaya. Now, there are lots more bananas than those. All of the bananas on the island are for local consumption, bananas and fruit. Now, the banana family is actually a very large family. More than 300 different species. They are your ornamentals, which would be like the heliconias or bird of paradise, as well as your traveler's palms. All ornamentals. And then you have your cooking bananas, like the plantains, and the buffets, which are very, very starchy. So you have to cook them, and you have to let them really get ripe. We also have a small banana, very sweet, called a fig. There's also the classic banana, which, of course, can be cooked when it's green. the green banana, you can peel it or you can peel it in the skin. It has not only a very high starchy content, it also has a high iron content, so that even if you are anemic, you can peel it, you can slice it, you can mash it just like potato. And we don't have a lot of wildlife or dangerous animals on the island. The Guinness Book of Records show we have the smallest grass snake in the world. It can fit on a quarter. We also have the mongoose, which the English at the time bought it to eat the rodents and snakes from the sugarcane fields, because we don't burn our sugarcane. If the crop catches fire, it's ruined, and some plantation owners actually have insurance on the fields, so if it burns, they get the insurance money. Now the monkey, the great monkeys, burbot monkeys, they have their origins in West Africa and would have come over with the dead slaves. There are lots of birds, the white cattle egrets, the West Indian grackle or blackbirds, the finches or the sparrows, and we also have the banana twit or yellow breast. What you have in Florida is a hybrid of our grapefruit. The tree here on the right with the blossoms, that's actually an avocado. There are lots of West Indian fruit trees close by. Also close by to us, coming up shortly on the left, is the Welshman Hall Gully. The Welshman Hall Gully is the loveliest of our botanical gardens. Right here on the left, again, we have 2,100 species of indigenous plants and trees in the Lesser Antilles. Only 700 of them can be found here, including two which are endemic to the island. Also close by is Harrison's Cave, which is a coral limestone cave with its stalactites, stalagmites, and underground crystal clear pools and streams and waterfalls. So we are actually in an area known as Highland, with our first stop coming up, Highland Adventure Center, where you'll be getting glimpses inside of the island. There are also going to be bathrooms.
What? This is about
as well. The bathrooms.
This is Highland.
You follow this little pathway all the way down to the bottom of the